News 3 Sophia Choi with a Crime Tracker 3 report.
Upon conducting a vehicle stop, we would run the registration. We would also run the driver to make sure they didn't have any outstanding warrants for their arrest and also to see if their license was valid.
Your greatest chance of dealing with a police officer is during a routine traffic stop. It's a situation, though, that can be pretty stressful for both you and the officer. So we're going to help you get through it with the least amount of difficulty in tonight's Friday Family Focus.
When you're pulled over, you might be thinking about what a ticket will cost you. But the officer's thoughts might be on an even higher cost.
We never know when we walk up to a car whether or not that is going to be the time when there was somebody sitting inside of that car with a handgun and they're going to attempt to shoot us.
The number one thing you can do is cooperate and make sure the officer knows it. That cooperation starts when you first see the flashing lights in your rearview mirror.
Take your foot off the gas, turn your turn signal on, and as soon as possible, as soon as it's safe to do so, pull to the right and stop your vehicle. Once you stop your vehicle, put it in park and take your foot off the brake. Turn off your radio. If it's at night, turn on the interior lights.
Whether it's a black and white or an undercover car, the rules are the same. We did a practice stop with Officer Thompson to show you what to expect.
Good morning, Las Vegas Metro Police. The reason I stopped you is you blew that stop sign back there.
Okay. Of course I didn't, but now isn't a time to argue.
We try to have a good relationship with the individuals that we cite, but trying to talk your way out of a ticket usually doesn't work.
Can I see your license, registration, and insurance, please?
Yes, sir. I believe it's in glove box.
Okay, go ahead and grab it for me.
Making sure you explain why you're going to reach somewhere and waiting for the officer to say it's okay reassures them you're not reaching for a weapon. And if there is one in the car,
tell that officer, sir or ma'am, I have a weapon. It is under the seat. It's in the glove box, wherever you might keep it.
All right, so the key is to not make any sudden moves and make sure the officer knows you're cooperating. You know, a lot of people ask, do I have the right to just pull over when I need to, or do I have to do it right away? Well, do it as soon as you feel safe. If that means going to a well-lit place with a wide shoulder, the key is just to slow down and click on your turn signals right away to let the officer know you do intend to stop once you feel safe.